is the one that I take. Never stops in between. A whole 3,000 mile road with one brief pause in Yellowstone. If the day comes in which you decide you want to with some and go for a drive, well, I'll be ready when you call.
Hey guys, so just finished up at the beach. I was there for almost exactly 2 hours. So I thought I was gonna spend like a lot more time there, and I like carved out my entire day just dedicated going to the beach. So I'm kind of at the point where I don't really know what to do with myself now, but I think I'm gonna get a burrito because that sounds just really good right now, and I'm really hungry. And little life update for you guys. So obviously I've moved, and well, not obviously, but I've posted a video about it if you want to check out my whole moving process. But I did move further down south in California, and so now I'm actually like by a beach. And yeah, school has yet to start. It starts in a couple days actually, but I've been spending a lot of time by myself because it's, you know, still summer and I'm in a new place where I don't know that many people. So a lot of days dedicated to solo adventures, to exploring, to all of that. I don't know, it's so easy to say that once you're in a different environment, you know, everything changes, which granted, like, I have been in a better headspace than I have been. Just honestly, this year has been a better year than the past couple years. So really grateful to obviously just feel good and like feel happy and be surrounded by people, places, and things that can bring that out of me. But that's not to say that, like, you know, moving to a different area or blank is gonna solve all your problems, because I've just been noticing myself in a really like heavy mood, like the second I wake up, like mainly just this past week. Honestly, I think it's because Mercury's in retrograde, which that bitch always affects me, so no surprise there. I have like this cycle, kind of like weird to put into words, but I have this like emotional cycle where it's like kind of on the dot too, every like month, like almost as if I'm like having my period, but like different. I'll get into a rut, and it's, if you guys know what Human Design is, it'll make sense, but if you don't, it's kind of like astrology, but for like learning about like the energy points in your body. I'm not really that qualified to describe it, so I don't really know how to describe it to the best of my ability, but my particular human design goes through that. Like, I literally get into a rut every like 3 or 4 weeks. So last week was its time to shine, and I just noticed myself focusing on the heavier things in my life, you know, the things that I can't control, focusing on anxiety and just like overthinking. I'm gonna move this because that's just not a good angle. But yeah, I was just noticing myself doing all of those things and falling back into old mindsets and all that. And I've just spent so much time working on going against that. So it was just, you know, annoying to kind of revisit those things. But just, I don't know, I'm really grateful to be in an area where, first of all, I'm by the ocean, which is just calming, like just on its own. But last night I actually took myself on a hot girl walk, and I've gone on walks before, but never to the extent of like what like a true hot girl walk is. Basically, the girl who created it, I guess, created the saying, said that if you're gonna go on a hot girl walk, there's rules, and those three rules are that you can only think of the things that you're grateful of, think of, I think, like the highest version of yourself or something like that, something along those lines, and how hot you are. So I was just feeling a little bit down, feeling a little heavy, so I was like, you know what, I'm gonna take myself on a hot girl walk and It did wonders. Honestly, I had, like, it carried throughout the rest of my day. I woke up in a better mood today, and it's helped me to focus on the, like, things I'm grateful for. So, you know, like, going to the beach, I, like, still found myself overthinking, and then I would catch myself and be like, wait, I'm at the beach right now. I'm by the ocean. I, you know, swam in the ocean a couple times, and I'm reading a good book. The sun is out. Like, why am I complaining? So, yeah, I just wanted to pop in and say that. It's all about your mind. It's not necessarily the circumstances you're in. Obviously, circumstances can help or deter you from, you know, growing. But I don't know what the moral of this story was. I don't even know. I honestly, like, start talking and then I, like, black out and I'm like, what have I been saying? Basically, just be grateful. I don't know what I was trying to give with that. Like, I don't really know what the point of that was. But anyways, I'm getting a burrito and I went to the beach, and that's all you need to know. I'm in a good headspace right now because I'm focusing on the things that really matter instead of being a pessimist or, you know, picking out all the other things that I could focus on. I'm focusing on the now, especially because school is starting soon. So I'm just focusing on the fact that it's still summer. I still have time to myself. And yeah, I'm gonna get a burrito, probably watch some Love Island, and take you along with me.